Snort, snort, snort coke.
Drip.
Snort, snort.
I got the drip gum.
Snort, snort, snort coke.
Drip.
Snort, snort.
I got the drip gum.
Damn. One of the major reasons why I've been talking to you about this car situation all week is because I wanted to conduct an experiment. All right? Everyone thinks I'm a dummy. All right? But I was actually setting the table to see what would happen if I talked about this and I revealed limited information about a situation that was really going on with me. Okay? So, congratulations to the people who fell for my trap and walked right into my hands. You have proven my point that I'm about to make. And I've said it before, but people don't believe me. But you fell for the fucking trap, hook, line, and sinker. All right? Here's the deal. I gave you guys half information all week about this because basically I didn't want people to know outright what was going on. I wanted to make it so that, you know, you don't know where I went, right? You don't know all the details. I told half details, right? On purpose. Because I've been telling you guys this for years, all right? I'm stalked on the internet. Literally stalked. Any piece of information someone can get about me or my personal life that is not involved with what I'm publicly displaying for you guys, okay, is seen as like some crazy golden nugget. Like, I'm serious. Like, they think like they went in a temple and they got through a bunch of booby traps to get to that golden goblet. You know, like the fucking, what is it? The chalice of life or the holy grail. They think that any little piece of menial information about me that's not public knowledge is somehow a giant piece of like enjoyment for these stalkers. Anything they can figure out. All right. Now, if you haven't noticed, in the last 5 years, all right, a lot has changed about me and my content. I became a full-time streamer, right? And that has been my focus. If you haven't noticed, in the last 5 years, I've completely and utterly phased out any kind of vlogging or any kind of video footage into my home outside of my office, right? My wife, right? You know, I met her, we started dating, she moved in with me, and we got married. All that's happened, and you've got very limited information about anything about our personal lives besides a few snippets. And I tell you, oh, we're watching The X-Files. What do we have for dinner today? But outside of that, I don't share a lot. And there's a very good reason for that, all right? Because these people are so obsessive for some reason. I'm a small-time guy. I don't make a lot of money on YouTube. I don't overall make a ton of money. Right? I don't get a lot of views. Right now, you would think, oh, Phil's about to expose a big thing that happened this week. The podcast has 500 viewers. Right? This podcast will probably have 1,000 views, if that, on my channel after the fact. I don't get a lot of viewership. I'm not Mr. Popular. No one really cares about me except these obsessed people. It's nuts that they are that obsessed. I don't even understand it. Why do you care so much about me, of all people? There's so many other people out there who are more notable and, sadly, I have to say it, probably a lot more interesting to know things about. I don't have all this crazy shit going on that's so interesting. You know what I'm saying? It just doesn't make sense to me that I get such obsessive people around me and my family. But the reason that I give you insanely limited information is just this reason, okay? Because these people are absolutely nuts with the amount and the lengths that they go to try to do stuff. So, this week, as all this was going on, I couldn't be on stream 2 days in a row. I was late because of this. I had to tell you what was going on, right? I had to tell you, this is what's happening. This is why I'm late. You know, I didn't do a fundraiser to try to pay for it. I wasn't doing anything crazy to try to go out of my way to make you guys pay for my car repair. That's fucking ludicrous. That was never my intention. Okay. my point was, I want to let you know why I was late. And at the same time, I wanted to conduct a social experiment to see what would happen if I gave you limited information about what was going on with my car repair this week and how this would end up by the end of the week, okay? This is going directly in line with my desire to do an interview with someone and talk about all the slander about me on the internet, all right? You're going to see how they connect in just a moment. So, why am I bringing all this up? What's the results of the experiment? I'll tell you the results of the experiment. Identity theft. Again. Which I thought was going to happen. All right? Here's what happened. Okay? Last night, someone on the internet went crazy. They decided to, number one, try to reach out to like every car repair place in a radius from my house. All right? I started getting emails, phone calls from a million car repair places. People had gone online and were trying to do online appointments and were basically trying to fish the system to find a place that had data on me, like an account in my name. Okay? So they found one and they went to the online chat system for that company, I guess, and they either did an online chat. I don't know if they actually called as well to try to impersonate me or whatever it is. I don't know what it was. But the thing is, as you guys know, my basic information was doxed a long time ago. My name, my address, my cell phone number, you know, basic info, okay? Let's be honest, car repair places don't get advanced info. They don't know anything more to really prove anyone's identity or anything like that. And let's also be honest, all right? People at a car repair place are not expecting that someone is trying to commit identity theft. What's the point? Like, right? What would be the point? Seriously, what is the point? There is no point because these places don't keep detailed records. They don't keep financial information. For example, there's no record in their system of the card that I used to pay for this transaction. You know, it's very limited. Legally, they can't have that in there because if they do that and then it leaks, I could sue them. So they don't even keep that. Once you pay, it just has very, okay, the transaction went through, but that's it. It doesn't like maintain any of your information or anything like that. It doesn't have my social security number. You know what I mean? It doesn't have all these things. There's nothing there. Okay, nothing at all. All right. But these people are so crazy. In their minds, I'm going to contact every car repair place in a radius from Phil's home to try to find the one he went to. And then I'm going to try to get this to say if Phil is lying or not about his car repair. All right. So I literally showed you this. Oh, I keep looking the wrong one. This is the scan that I did last night when I got home. Oh, this is the actual page from the invoice. The only thing I've removed is the name of the company, who it was with, right? And, you know, statistics about shit on my car and stuff like that. Nothing major, nothing crazy. What's funny about this is that their system isn't even right, because one of the pages here says that my car has 60,000 miles, which is wrong. My car just hit 10,000 miles, which it even says in the description here. If you take a look where it says Dexo specialty oil change up to 5 quarts, it says the manufacturer recommends an oil change based on your mileage of 10,000 miles, which I just hit. But then it says 60,000 miles at the top of the screen, which is wrong. It's like outright wrong. Okay. Yeah, but basically this information is nothing that's a big deal. All right. Literally, there's nothing here that's, you know, the name of the place I went to have my car repair done. Not a big deal. The name and address, you know, basic information about the car. It's nothing special. Okay. So I don't know what they were looking to get by committing identity theft again against me to try to get this. I mean, I don't know. You know, again, these businesses, they're not going to keep my information or whatever, like payment information or something, if that's what they were getting at or whatever. I don't know why they would even think that. It's nuts. Okay. Maybe they thought I was outright lying about the whole situation, again, to get sympathy from my audience and try to get you guys to pay for the car repair. If that was the case, wouldn't I have done a stream asking for you to pay for the car repair, which I did not? Right? You know what I'm saying? Like, wouldn't I have done that? I didn't. So again, in their broken minds, they make these crazy assumptions, these crazy things. What was the point of doing this? Zero. It did absolutely nothing. I already told you guys I was going to show you today anyway, the stuff, right? So it doesn't even matter. But I had a feeling this week with this going on, they were going to pull something like this. Okay. Now, what information did you guys even have? Think about it. All you knew is that I went somewhere local to get my car repaired. That's it. That's all you knew. Nothing else. I didn't tell you where. I didn't tell you, you know, nothing. But to them, this was worthwhile. Let's commit identity theft. Let's try to contact every repair place and say, hey, you know, I need a copy of my invoice because I lost it or whatever. I don't even know what they said. All right. So apparently they got it. I don't know. I mean, I can't confirm or deny. Again, I don't go to these fucked up places. I don't, you know, but people are telling me today they got it. It's not a big deal. Again, there's nothing here that's any kind of risk or anything. It's no big deal at all. All right. But the thing that's hilariously stupid about all of this is that they 100% fell into my trap and actually proved my point all along. All right. Here is what I've been saying for years and years. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I can finally use this as the concrete evidence that what I've been saying is true. They can't even fucking deny it anymore. All right. You ready for this? I've been accused of so many things on the internet. Having secret PayPal accounts that I embezzle money in that I hid during my bankruptcy proceedings. Lying under oath during my bankruptcy proceedings about all kinds of various different things. Spending everyone's money frivolously on dumb shit like liquor and mobile gaming and all of this shit and all of that shit, right? All this stuff. And it happens daily at this point. It's to the point where it's a joke. At this point, it's a running meme. It's stupid. But I'm so tired of it that, like, that's why I want to do an interview and say, no, here's the real truth of what's going on. And these people just want to keep fucking with me so badly that it becomes a truth that they reiterate as if it's real when it's not. It's not real. Okay? So, I purposely did it this way this week to see what would happen if I gave you limited information on something to try to just say, hey, this is real. This happened. You know, in reality, they went faster than I thought they would. Because I thought, honestly, today, here's what I would do. I would do this, and I would say, hey, guys, here's the invoice. Here's what I paid. And I thought those guys would use what I just showed you on the stream in order to try to, like, reverse engineer where the repair was done. And they would have all that information on the internet by the end of the week. That's what I thought. They fucking did it before that. They actually, like I said, they actually went out of their mind. Okay? To lie, to commit identity theft, identity fraud, and get a copy of the invoice from the place, obviously without my permission, before I even showed you anything. You know what I'm saying? I didn't even do anything yet. I just gave you very generalized information. So what's hilarious about this is they fell right into my hands. And here's what I mean by that. Over the years, all this slander is put about me on the internet. And what happens every time that the slander gets put out? I'll say to you guys, it's not true, right? It's just not. It's based on a nugget of truth. It's spun out of hand. It's over-exaggerated to become a conspiracy that's not based on fact. What they do is they find little pieces of information here and there. They draw these crazy conspiracy webs between them to say that they're factual, okay? Perfect example of this was that escort bullshit. Where when I was first dating my wife, they were trying to say I wasn't really dating anyone. It was an escort I was paying and flying over from Europe. And it was just the most ludicrous thing that people believed for months because they were that fucking stupid. They were dying to believe a conspiracy. Now, that one was disproven. But then what ended up happening was they went right into the next one and the next one and the next one. And ever since then, I mean, this was, what, 2017? Ever since 2017, 2018, when that was happening, they've just never stopped. It's just been conspiracy, 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 conspiracy. Now, why do they do it? There's two reasons. The first reason they do it is because it gets them clickbait, it gets them attention, it gets them to talk about drama, it gets them all worked up. These people are immature. They love this kind of shit. This is very much like the Keemstar audience. This is the kind of people that they don't even care if what they're looking at is real or not. They just want to believe it. And you'll tell them a million times that's really unlikely. They don't care. They just want to believe anything. For the sake of having drama. They want to believe every negative thing about a YouTuber and try to bring them down because it makes them feel like they're better, right? It makes them feel better about their own lives. And at the same time, they get some kind of weird satisfaction out of like hurting someone on the internet and they have no repercussions for it, okay? So regardless of any of it is true or not, as long as they say something negative about me, they're happy that they got away with it, all right? But here's the other half of it, all right? Here's the other half. They know that with the kind of accusations, all right, the other accusations that these people make against me, the kind that they are, they know that the only way that I could ever prove, say, innocence against the things that they accuse me of would be to show you guys private information or to give you talk about private things, like, for example, financial institutions who I've worked with, showing you, like, some idiot actually wrote me an email the other day and said, show me a copy of your bank statement. Some idiot actually wrote that in an email to me. Show me your bank statement to prove your innocence. Like, this is what they want. Now, here's the thing. All right? I could do that. I could do the things that they want. All right? I could. Now, what would happen if I did? Here's your hard evidence of exactly what would happen if I were to do what they want. They would take any piece of information whatsoever that they could get from something that I provided to you guys as evidence of my innocence of the shit that they accused me of, and they would reverse engineer it. They would use it to find the next piece, the next piece, the next piece. It's essentially a never-ending trap, all right? It's called, number one, it's called moving the goalpost, because even if I disprove the things they say, they'll always have something else to accuse me of, because that's how they operate. Remember, they get their jollies off of creating drama and conspiracy on the internet, so even if something's ridiculously false or not so ridiculously false, they don't care, okay, at all. They don't care. They'll still keep saying fucked up things to keep that gravy train moving for them, all right? What they want is for me to make a horrible mistake. They want me to actually put my personal information, even if it's edited heavily, right? Whatever it may be. They want me to put that shit on the internet in some form so they can reverse engineer it and hurt me. That's been one of their intentions all along. You know, why do you think they're doing it? Because they're like, man, I really want to get that guy. And right now we've tried everything. We tried getting him banned from YouTube. It doesn't work. We tried hitting him with copyright strikes. It doesn't work. We tried slandering his name all over the internet. Oh, look, sometimes you have various levels of success, you know, but sometimes you don't. And the thing is, I'm still here after 14 years and literally after about 10 straight years of online harassment of various levels, right? I'm still here. I'm still having a great time with my audience every single day on stream. I'm still having a business that I really enjoy because it's what I love, but I get to do it for a living. Like, I'm still here. I'm not going anywhere. All the shit that they've tried to do to me over the years has not been successful at all. All right? It's just not going to. It's never going to be. Yes, there'll be various days when they annoy me, and there's various days when they kind of fuck with me, and there's not much I could do about that. All right? But that being said, I'm never going to go away. I'm still going to make content if I so desire. I'm still going to be here. Nothing's going to change. You know what I'm saying? Everything that they're doing is annoyance, but it's not anything that's ever going to say, oh, no, we finally got him off of YouTube or whatever. That's never going to happen. Never. Never. Doesn't matter what they do or say or how much shit they make up. That will never happen. And I'm basically very happy to know that I have such a supportive viewer base that you guys know the bullshit. And you enjoy my content every day regardless of it, all right? But basically, they're never going to give up. I know that. I'm not stupid, all right? So this week, with all of this already going on, I purposefully did this to see what would happen. And they did exactly what I thought. They broke the law, they committed identity fraud, and they got personal information that they shouldn't have. The good news is the personal information isn't damning and doesn't hurt. It's nothing that's really going to negatively affect me in any way. However, yes, it's annoying that this has happened because they shouldn't have access to that personal information whatsoever. It should be private, personal, all right? Just because I said I got my car repaired on the internet shouldn't immediately mean that every piece of data about the car repair is now public, okay? It's bullshit. It's really fucked up, okay? So the thing is, a couple things to learn from this. Thing number one is, yes, absolutely, I have to be careful about the things I say and do on the internet. There very well may be days when something goes wrong and I cannot be here live on the stream on time, in which I'm just going to have to say, I'm sorry, guys. I literally can't tell you why I'm late, because if I do, I'm putting myself and my family at personal risk because these idiots do this kind of stuff. They'll try to figure out what it is. They'll commit crimes just to get a very small, stupid piece of information that is not important, but they'll still do it. Okay? It's pretty fucked up. Now, in addition to this, this ties directly into my desire to have a public interview with a, you know, a bigger person than me on the internet so people hear my responses and answers, all right, to everything that's going on with the slander against me. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I now have the justification right here in my fucking hands of why all I can do is give my side of the story, but I hate to say it, I can't provide any real concrete corroborating evidence to back it up. Because if I did, if I showed you a bank statement with blacked out parts, if I showed you my accounts on my phone, which some people have said, just open your phone and show us all your accounts. Oh, that sounds like a really smart idea, doesn't it, right? The moment I do that, seriously, this will all be reverse engineered. It'll be impersonations out the ass to try to get access to all of my information. All right? You did it for a dumb fucking car repair that means nothing. Right? You had your chance and you 100% fell hook, line, and sinker for my trap and proved that you're so crazy that even for something as dumb as this, that doesn't matter. It means nothing. It affects nothing. You still did it anyway. So now imagine if I were to open my phone and show you an account that I have or to, you know, show you a bank statement. That would be the end of everything. They would probably try to steal all my money. They would try to shut down all of my accounts. They would definitely try to impersonate me in any way they could to hurt me and my family. Would I have to be a complete fucking idiot? One of the dumbest people on earth to show you anything, right? So, congratulations. Really, congratulations to the morons who did this overnight. You have literally in one action destroyed any chance whatsoever that I would ever show you anything personal. You ruined it for yourself. Because this week, as I've been talking with various people of different levels on YouTube, and also as I've been talking with other people, one of the points that has come up, all right? One of the points that's come up is, do you have anything concrete that you can show to prove that what these people are saying is false? Which is hilarious because in a court of law, you're innocent until proven guilty. There's absolutely positively nothing whatsoever about me on the internet that is factually true like this that proves me guilty of anything. Zero. Nothing. There's nothing that can prove anything that they've been saying. Okay? You know what I'm saying? Nothing at all. But for me to disprove the things that they're saying on the internet, I have to show you factually true information. When I do that, I am now exposing myself. That is exactly what they've wanted all along. All right? This has always been their game. Let's make it so much of a pain for Phil that he will be dumb enough to actually show us something real, and now we've got him. Because now we can absolutely, positively destroy this guy. Right? So, when people say, oh, Phil, you're just paranoid. No, I'm not. Here is your factual fucking evidence that I'm not paranoid in any way. They literally just did this. Overnight, they committed identity theft. They impersonated me. And they tried to fuck with me and realize, oh, there's nothing here. Right? But if something that stupid, they went to that length. Again, can you imagine if I showed you anything personal from my life, what they would do with it, okay? Seriously, like if one of these accounts gets compromised, that could be ruining, you know? They could destroy my not that I have credit because of my bankruptcy, but they could go even further. They could try to steal all my money. They could try to ruin all of my accounts. Like I always tell this story, and people think I made it up. It's not. It's 100% true. Years ago, I was doing a vlog in my kitchen of some sort. I couldn't even tell you what it was. It might have been a DSP Tries It. I had accidentally left my invoice for my power company, my electric bill. I had left it on the countertop of my counter when I was filming this episode of DSP Tries It, okay? Just at a glance, the camera had panned over there and showed the company, all right? My detractors called the electric company, impersonated me, and tried to get my electricity turned off. The only reason I knew this is because I had set up automatic email notifications for anything that happens with that account. And I got an email overnight saying, you're scheduled to have your power turned off on Monday as the earliest that we could do it for you. I was like, what? So, of course, I immediately called them. I explained the situation. And what we ended up doing is putting in multiple levels of security to prevent anyone from being able to impersonate me in the future and do anything against me like that. You know, and then I had to go and do that with many other companies and things like that. But this is what I mean. And this was years ago. This was before all the current shit that's going down with me right now. This was many years ago. So that's what I mean. Like, this stuff is so ridiculous. All right. And based on what, you know, what horrible act did I commit to have my life like this? Right. Seriously, what did I do? What heinous crime? There's people out there who they're being exposed for running gambling rings with children, right? There's people out there who are blatant, outright, 100% scamming, you know? People out there who have done insanely harmful things to people all over the internet, all right? We know this. It's public documentation of this. I'm the one who gets this treatment. But what the hell did I do? Did I do immature, dumb things over a decade ago? Yes, I did. I said dumb, irresponsible things on the internet in my old content. I'm aware of that. I've apologized for it. I've watched documentaries on it, cringed at it, said, wow, I'm glad I'm not like that anymore. Since 2017, when I actively started to change as a person, okay, I've made a concerted effort to become better, you know, because I love what I do for a living. I don't want to lose that to some nonsense. So I've done my best. I've changed my life. I met a woman who has changed my life as well, a soulmate who I live with and will be with forever, who we have a great life together here. And we don't want to put anything like that at personal risk. You know, it'd be crazy to do so. You know, so it's just funny because people want to always say things like, again, you're paranoid, or, you know, the real reason is because, you know, you're guilty of everything. No. The real reason is because look at what happens with something so meaningless as a car repair. They fall right into my hands and do exactly as I thought they would. Now imagine if I actually put out something that could actually put me at major risk. Yes, if a financial account, if a phone account, if, I mean, there's a million things. If any of those things ever were to become at high risk, I mean, just to give you some perspective here, there's something called two-factor authorization, for those who don't know. Here's how it works. You need to sign into a site that's very important to you, all right? So you put your name and password in. Well, you set up two-factor authorization. So now they send a special code to you via, whether it's an email address, a cell phone number, whatever it may be. They send that to you as another level of security to make it authentic, to prove that you're who you say you are. So usually that goes through a phone or an email address, all right? The reason this is so important is because there's people who try to break into accounts all the time, especially mine. You know, all the time, this is a constant. If I didn't have two-factor authorization, all my shit would have been messed up years and years ago. Thank God I did it as soon as it was available on all these accounts. Now, can you imagine if I open up this phone, okay, and I show you stuff on the phone to prove innocence for one thing, but based off of that, they now have information they can use to get stuff off my phone. Now, anytime I go for two-factor authorization, they have that data, and now they have access to all my other accounts. Done. That's not paranoia. That's what they're doing. That's what this is. That's what all this is. That's what they're exactly what they're trying to do. You understand? So, Phil, if you're going to do an interview, you better go on that interview with concrete evidence. No. You know what? You had a chance because I was considering, I'm being very honest with you all now. If I was going to do a tell-all interview with someone, I was thinking, gee, I should go to this person perhaps with all this information, present it to them, right? And then we pick and choose what we show, what we don't show. At this point, I'm not going to show a fucking thing. There's no point because if I do, these idiots could use it to hurt me. I'm not going to put my family at risk because someone's slandering me on the internet about a fucking mobile game or some dunce-level bullshit that's not true. I'm not stupid, you know? This is crazy that I have to actually think about this. But I do. This is my life now. Like, everything that I did. Seriously. Everything I touch, everything I do, I have to think twice about it. Anyone else on the planet can say, nothing's ever at risk, I'm fine, no worries. Literally everything that I touch, I have to be worried about, is this putting me at risk? Is this exposing me? Is this going to possibly somehow be made public later and it could hurt me? That's fucked up to think about, isn't it? It's really fucked up to think about it. But that's my life now. And there's nothing I can really do about it, man. I gotta do what's best for me and my family. So you absolutely, positively had a chance to actually have me show concrete stuff to disprove what people were going to say on the internet. I used this week as a test. It was just a coincidence this happened. Obviously, I had no idea my car was going to break down. But when it happened, I said, ah, aha, eureka. Here's what we can do. Let's see what happens, because maybe I'll be proven wrong. Maybe the nonsense has calmed down and these people have actually become intelligent and they won't do the horrible thing. They won't commit the crime to impersonate me and try to get my personal information. You know what I'm saying? Maybe not. Maybe I am paranoid. They did it faster than I anticipated. I didn't even have to show you the invoice yet and they had already fucking done it. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, there you have it, guys. When these idiots say things like, why doesn't Phil just prove what's wrong, that what we say about him is wrong? I'll tell you why. Number one, because I'm innocent until proven guilty. No one has proven a damn thing. All they've done is created conspiracy theory after conspiracy theory. I've seen entire giant chat logs from Discord servers that have like my name in them. That's not me. I literally never typed a fucking line on there. So they fabricated, it's like hundreds of hours of work of the shit that they've created. This nonsensical web that somehow they've spun to create their crazy theories about me that are not true. But it's just so insane that it's gotten to that level. And they think, oh, well, because Phil doesn't say, you know, doesn't disprove it. No, I'm innocent until proven guilty. You still haven't proven anything. All you've done is just kept reiterating the same conspiracies to the point where now people believe them as fact because they're stupid. If you believe a conspiracy theory with no hardcore evidence, right? You fucked up. You're an idiot. There's so many of them out there. Now, I'm not saying don't be skeptical and believe everything you're told by the authorities or whatever, right? Even me, you know, you have a right to question things that I say and do. Everyone does. You know, you shouldn't just believe absolutely 100% everything everyone says as honesty and truth. Because you know, everyone has a spin on everything. Everyone has a subjective take, right? Not everyone's an objective person. Everyone has a subjective take on everything. You know that. If you're an intelligent person, you know that, all right? But no one has proven anything. And they won't. Do you want to know why they won't? Because it's all false. Don't you think at this point, right? There would have been something. There's nothing. It's just, here's another level of bullshit I created. Here's another level of bullshit that I created on top of the other bullshit. Let's just keep piling the bullshit. And it's now like a skyscraper of bullshit. But if you haven't noticed, I didn't take the bait. I have not given out information that would hurt me because I'm not stupid. So I sit here and I take all their shit and I'm like, whatever. But you know what? I'm able to still operate a business. I'm still safe. I don't have all of our personal information compromised. I don't have people trying to reverse engineer all my accounts and steal them. I don't have, you know what I mean? Last year was scary because there was someone who had access to one of my accounts and basically tried to take a lot of money from me. All right. That's the truth of the matter. Because what they try to say about it is that there's bank leaks and shit. None of that happened. What happened was I had someone who actually tried to take money from me. And luckily for me, all right, I had alerts set up. And also, I didn't even have the money that they were trying to take. I guess they thought I was a liar. And I have tons of money sitting around in my accounts and stuff. You know, I didn't have the money. It still cost me a lot of time and money to fix. Because accounts had to be completely closed. New accounts had to be opened. I had payment arrangements for various different institutions that were voided because I had no money to pay them now. So now everything, I got late fees, violation fees, new calculations had to be done. And by the end of the day, that identity theft that I had last year cost me several thousand dollars to fix. You know, and then these idiots say, oh, Phil, you know, it's your own fault you're in financial distress. Well, to some extent, yeah, I'm the one who got me originally in it. But every time things start to go better for me, and I get to a point where it looks like things are going to get better, this kind of shit keeps happening, and it sets me back again and again and again, right? So what am I supposed to do? You know, people keep fucking with me. If they would just leave things alone, here's the thing. People say the thing they hate the most about me is that I'm a beggar on my streams. I just keep asking for my fans for support, okay? If you would leave me the fuck alone and not do this, and not try to fuck with everything that I'm doing, if you would leave me alone, I wouldn't have to do it anymore. I'd be in a position where I don't have money draining out of every orifice because you keep fucking with all the things in my life. Within a few years here, as I've told you, I have a plan. My hope is that eventually my credit gets better and I can do something with my credit that now I can get out of the back debts that I have. Those will be settled. I'll have enough to now keep up on all my monthly stuff every month. You know what I'm saying? Excuse me. This is my plan. I do have a plan. I absolutely have a plan. But I need the plan to work, and I can't have it work if at every moment you got an idiot impersonating me over here trying to fuck with me. You got someone doing this, doing that. The things that these people claim they hate to see me do, it's the reason why they abuse me, can't go away if they keep abusing me. You see what I'm saying? They're creating this vicious cycle, this reciprocant cycle. If they would leave me alone and not fuck with all of this stuff and make me having to blow money on shit and do dumb shit, this would all be better. But they won't leave it alone. So in a reality, what it is they like, you know what they call it? They like to see the train wreck, right? Oh, everyone wants to see the car crash. Everyone wants to see the train wreck. So the truth is, the reason we do it is because Phil begs. Wrong. The reason they do it is because they want to see me suffer. That's the truth. They're doing it because they want to see Dark Side Phil Burnell, suffer. They like seeing me squirm. They like seeing me in pain. They are fucked up sociopaths. That's why these people do these things and say the things that they do. They do it for personal gain, and they get personal enjoyment out of it. There's no crusade against Dark Side Phil to say, oh, he's doing something wrong, that's why we're punishing him. They just like the punishment. They like the idea that the things they do are anonymous, they can't get in trouble for them, and then they get away with it scot-free while they get to see me be suffering here in real life. All right? That's the reason. That is the true diagnosis of what's happened with me on the internet over the last 10 years since This Is How You Don't Play started. At first, it became a joke about how bad Phil's gameplay is, but then it became, oh shit, we get a lot of pleasure out of seeing that guy suffer. Let's keep it up. Let's dox him. Let's SWAT him. Let's DDoS attack him. Let's hit him with false copyright strikes. Let's completely harass him and all of his family members up, down, left, and all around. Let's fabricate a million conspiracy theories and stories about the man until he breaks. And then one day he's going to be on stream, he's going to break down, he's going to cry, and we're going to laugh. I'm not going to break down. I'm still here. I will be here for as long as I desire to be, all right? None of this is going to change because of you. You have no power over me whatsoever because the things you say are wrong. They're false. If they were true, something at some point would have been proven and happened. Nothing has. It's the same bullshit you say about me every day because you have nothing. You made it all up. Like I said, maybe a nugget of truth. You're never going to get me to stop doing what I love and do meaningful content for the audience that I have a great relationship with. This is means too much to me and means too much to people all over the world. Even as small time as I am now compared to how I used to be, and you think, oh, look at the success we've had running him off the internet, I'm still here and I'm never going away unless I choose to do it. Maybe you can get someone else off the internet if you try, if you're really resilient. But DSP, Dark Side Phil, is not going anywhere because of you. This shit doesn't scare me. This shit is exactly what I expected. You fell for the trap. You proved my point. And now I know that if I do a tell-all interview, I just can't show anything concrete because of that. That now is my actual justification for saying there's too much risk involved because of what these people have done to me. Congratulations. You screwed yourself. Much like how years ago, my wife used to like to try to show up on the streams and wanted to be a part of things. And you harassed her on my Halloween stream and made her feel like shit, like human garbage. Since then, which has been now 4 years, she hasn't appeared in a piece of my content, all right? Very well justified, too. And everyone wants to say, oh, it wasn't so bad. It was horrible. It was insanely bad with the things that were said and done on that stream, even with mods and everything. You know, there's not much you could do to shut it down. And now these people, ever since that day, say, oh, it's a shame that Kat's not in Phil's content anymore. You're the reason. You fucked it up. Not me, not her, you. Because if you didn't do that, she probably would have been in my content a lot more. We might have done co-op playthroughs. We might have done co-commentary on things. We might have done special vlogs together for the holidays and other things. We, like I said, we were actually talking about doing Cooking with the King and Queen, where it was more going to be her cooking and me just helping and doing a whole series like this. You actually screwed yourselves out of the content you wanted by harassment. So, congratulations. You just did it again. You fell for my bait. And now you've proven that you will never give up. And you're going to, as little and meaningless as that piece of information was about my car repair, you shot yourself in the foot and you ruined any chance of ever getting anything out of me. And you have no one to blame but yourself. So whoever did that, if it was one person, if it was multiple people, I want you to look in the fucking mirror right now. Or since you probably don't own a mirror, you probably have a phone, all right? Open your camera, turn on the selfie mode, and take a picture of yourself and stare at the dumbest motherfucker on the planet. Because you fucked it up. I was legitimately considering doing a tell-all interview with someone and actually showing concrete information to show my innocence. But because of you, the dumbest motherfucker on the planet, I'm not doing that anymore. It's too risky. I mean, holy shit, you're dumb. I can't imagine someone being more stupid. Because you could have had it all. You could have had stuff to work with. You could have created a whole new line of conspiracy theories. Instead of having to repeat the same ones over and over like you do on a daily basis, you would have had all new shit to work with, I'm sure. And you fucked it up for yourself because you're so dumb. Man, that's incredible stupidity. Congratulations, you win the Dummy of the Decade Award. I can't believe how dumb you are. Significant stupidity there. So there you have it. So why is this story creepy? Because I now know that literally any little piece of meaningless information that I give anyone on the internet is going to be used to try to get shit about me and hurt me. So now I'm just not going to give you anything anymore. It's done. You know, like I said, if I happen to have a day when I'm late to stream, I'm just not going to tell you what it is anymore. I'm sorry I was late, you know, personal shit. And that's it. Because even something as silly as this can explode into something insanely negative. All right. If there was something going on here with where I really need help. Like I said, if I was in a situation where I couldn't even pay for this, right? What if I hadn't gotten paid by YouTube last week and I had no money to even afford getting my car back? Yeah, then I would tell you and we would do in a special event or whatever if I need help from the viewers. But thankfully, that wasn't the situation. The problem now is I need to have several good weeks to essentially make up for the fact that I just dropped $1,000 I wasn't planning on spending to even afford my basic shit around here. So I'm hoping for great support and good stuff coming with the new releases and everything. But I'm, you know, that's it. This was it. My test worked. I was 100% successful. Proved my point. Thank you for corroborating everything I've been saying over the years about your level of obsession. You proved how crazy you are. Now I don't even have to justify anymore the fact that I don't have to show you anything because people are like, oh, you're paranoid. No, I'm not. You just actually proved it because you're so fucking dumb.
Okay. I got the drip gum. 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 I got the drip gum.
Can't make it stop. So what do you want me to do? Have a mute button that every second I'm tapping the mute button just in case I'm gonna have to clear. Like, this is what I mean. These dumb kids. This is what it is. It's dumb kids.